Welcome back to Happily Ever Hanks. We have a really fun topic for you guys because we're talking about all the stuff we think you should do if you're visiting Florida. Yes, we're talking to you, snowbirds.
I feel like we've been spending a lot of time in Florida. I'm ready to skedaddle out of Florida, but before we do, we always want to bring the best information to you guys just in case you're on your way down here yourself. Look, we got a lot to cover. Got some good ones coming at you. Probably ones you never even heard of, because we're not talking about just Disney or anything weird like that.
Heck no.
We'll kind of dip the toes in the water. We'll always save the best for last, because we just gotta keep you hanging in there. You know how the Hanks like to do it. I did it. I watched the second Top Gun once again. I'm a big Top Gun nut, and that actually leads me right into our first one of go check out the Blue Angels.
Ooh, the U.S. Navy, located in Pensacola, Florida. Right up in the panhandle is one of the U.S. Naval Air Stations. We watched them from the rooftop when we were camping at Big Lagoon State Park.
Oh, I love that state park.
We went up there, took a little beverage, and then we got to watch them do some cool maneuvers for free.
And what you mean by up there is literally we got on top of our roof and just sat there and got like a free show. Best part is they do all these practices twice a week. I think it's like Tuesdays and Wednesdays. They're like flying low and super fast over your camper.
We went to the Sun and Fun Air Expo show in Lakeland. I think it was around April and they do it every year. So you get to see all sorts of stuff going on there, and the Blue Angels make an appearance. They do a couple other shows throughout the year. In July, they do a beach air show. So in Pensacola, Florida, or surrounding areas, you can post up on the beach. Also, they do a homecoming show in November.
If you guys like the adrenaline, fast pace, definitely go look at them because the Blue Angels are bringing it and nothing less.
There is the National Aviation Museum in Pensacola, Florida, but as of now, the only people who can get in are Department of Defense holders. But you can take up to 15 people with you. Per the website, this is what they said, and it is free.
Wow, that was a mouthful.
And just in case you're wondering, there is RV parking at the museum. It's a little loud though, so have your earplugs ready.
So what I want to say for you to do next is definitely, if you have the chance, go down to the Everglades and get yourself on an airboat tour.
If you're feeling the need for speed again, Carl.
Yeah, you know what else I did not have an idea about? Is how hard it is to say airboat tour.
Airboat tour.
Tongue twister. So when you get out there, imagine yourself, you're cruising along 30, 40 miles an hour, wind in your hair, so much wildlife to see, guys. It is ridiculous.
If you are from the north and you're like, I've never seen a gator, I wanna go see a gator. When we went on this airboat tour, we were just right up close personal with gators all over. It was so, so cool. How much does it cost? Well, I'm glad you asked. There's lots of companies that do this, and it's roughly around $50 per person, depending on who you go, if you wanna do a public tour, meaning you're gonna be with other people.
You get these like little headsets, kinda helps block out all that noise that you're having from the airboat, and you can have direct communication with your guide, which is really cool because they have all sorts of stories and stuff to share with you about what's going on out there.
Little tip for you guys, if you're doing the airboat tour and you have the headset on like this with the microphone, think Backstreet Boys. And what I mean by that is put that microphone really close to your mouth. Get in there with the microphone and be like, I want it that way.
Girl! Are you done now?
Tell me why! But yes, you can talk to like your guide and everyone on the boat. For the most part, you and I were just like, the whole time we
were like, can you still hear me? I'm like,
we didn't do any other companies. We obviously just know about Down South airboat tours, but we had a wonderful experience. And for him and I to do the private tour, it ended up costing $280 is what we paid. Not including the tip. Don't forget to tip your guides.
Yeah.
If you're not looking for gators or loud noises like the past two, you want to go check out Devil's Den Spring.
Something pristine off one of those travel videos that you're like, how do I ever get there? Where are these people finding these places? Well, it's actually in Williston, Florida, and it's very popular there, and you can go anytime.
There is an RV park close by, and there's tons of lodging and stuff available in the area.
So Nene and I went scuba diving that day. We are certified divers, so we just went on our own. But if you're not scuba diving, you can also go snorkeling. But just know, you cannot go and just jump in and swim around on your own. You either have to be snorkeling or scuba diving.
Yeah, this spring is privately owned.
Now, cool part is, it is like a spring that stays around 72-ish degrees, I would say. You can get down to like 50 foot deep if you're diving. There are some fish in there, and it's like crystal clear water, which is really cool. And imagine it's like a huge cave with just sun pouring in from the top. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. So if you want to do kind of like a once in a lifetime experience with the family, easily accessible, go check it out. Devil's Den is where it's at.
But just know, if you are not swimming, you can't even get down the steps to see the spring, because that is only accessible for people going to snorkel or dive.
But it is cool. You can stand around the top of the area and look down on the swimmers, which is neat too.
Now, we went diving there, but I'm going to share with you that to get the best experience, I think you're just fine snorkeling, because when you dive there, it gets very dark very fast. But all the beauty was kind of near the top,
I would say, because the sunlight's pouring in from the top and the light only goes down so far. So obviously the more you descend, the darker it is. There's not much to see other than rocks and some portions that split off into the caves below, which obviously we didn't do that because we're not that crazy. We don't ever want to go cave diving. That's insane.
Yeah, that was kind of intimidating when I saw the Grim Reaper signs everywhere.
Don't
go
beyond this unless you want to die. I'm like, I'm going to head this way.
Let's go this way,
Nene. Yeah. Maybe we're going a little too fast pace. You're more of a person that likes to chill on the beach, cold drink in the hand. Hear me out. We have some inside tips on how you gain better access to the Florida Keys, especially if you're doing the RV thing. Well, we landed. When we went to Bahia Honda. State Park, and that's where we stayed for like a week. Let me tell you, being in the Keys is the closest you can get to like literally being in the Bahamas. Now, the cool part is you can also go visit the most southern point of the United States while down in the Florida Keys. It's so unique down there. Yeah. It's just really cool. There's a bunch of different keys as you progress along more southern in your trip, and you're going over like these super long bridges.
Just know, jacked up prices when it comes to everything. Groceries, fuel, RV parks. I would say the average stay for RV parks is around $100 per night, but look out for those key deer. They're everywhere and they're cute.
Is that a dog or a deer? All the locals are like, that's a deer, bro.
Yeah, I'm
like,
that's a deer. Calm down.
I didn't know that.
If you're looking to visit the Keys and you're nervous about snowbird season down there, try visiting off season, like a shoulder season. Besides Bahia Honda State Park, there's also John Pennekamp State Park and Curry Hammock State Park. Silver Springs State Park is probably one of the coolest state parks in Florida.
I feel like it was. We went out on our paddleboards. You could just take a nice leisure down the river at your own pace. And it's a hit and miss as whether or not you're gonna see those monkeys out there. We personally saw them. They came up like literally on the lowest branches. And I thought at one time it was literally gonna jump on my paddleboard. I was like, dude, this guy is gonna jack my Dorito chips right on my hand, and he was eyeballing them hardcore.
Silver Springs is well known for their glass bottom boat tours. We've heard of a lot of people doing these, and they were able to see some awesome wildlife while on this boat, and they're getting a tour guide. Look it up on the internet. It used to be an amusement park back in like the 1950s or 60s.
Yes.
But when Disney came around, gave that place the boot.
That was it, huh?
It had to close down. What can you do at Silver Springs? There's some hiking, you can go paddling, those boat tours I was telling you about. They even have restaurants there. Like, this state park's legit. They got it all.
You just can't go swimming there, can you?
You can't swim, so don't bring your inner tubes. We took our paddle boards, and if you want to bring your own boat, there is a $4 launch fee per vessel, and then $2 per person to get in. So we paid a total of $12 to go paddle and see the monkeys and hang out. It's funny because if you go to Silver Springs website, they say nothing about monkeys because I think they're trying to not encourage people to come.
Really?
With the monkeys.
Oh, interesting.
If you don't have your own boat, no worries. You can rent kayaks, you can have guided tours, they do a shuttle service. It's sweet. All there. And you can book it all through the website, which I thought was really cool.
If you want to see the breakdown of how Happily Ever Hanks tackled Silver Springs State Park, we'll leave the link in a video above. Go check out that one after watching this video. But moving right along, I do feel like you're hitting on these history points though. Is there anything else that you want to describe?
How about the oldest city in America? St. Augustine, Florida.
Being in St. Augustine is a little more laid back, a little more chill, a lot more history.
Yeah, it is a touristy area, so you can do trolley tours and like haunted tours because supposedly it's a very haunted, spooky city. Definitely add a visit to America's oldest city if you're heading to Florida.
So we finally did it. It was one of our bucket list items for the longest time. We went swimming with manatees, and this is the only place in America you can do it, which is so much awesomeness going on in like one location.
Also known as sea cows, or what I like to call floating potatoes. Crystal River, Florida is like the name of the area where they have three Sisters Spring, and it is the only manatee sanctuary where you can actually swim with them. Like, they don't allow it anywhere else in Florida except Crystal River.
Get in the water and, like, up close within inches of your face are these immaculate creatures. Yeah. It was so cool to see.
And they're harmless, and really all you need to do is just float in the water and they will just swim right past you.
They are awesome. Yeah, they are
so
big
cute.
Potatoes.
They are.
They do like this in the water. They're like... And they just like float. And Nene said, see the potato and be the potato. Like, that's all you gotta do.
You definitely said potato like you were from the Northeast.
Shoot. I am not from the Northeast. I'm from the West. Oh my God.
Last year, a year ago, it was February of 2022. We went with Fun to Dive Charters. They took us out in a boat. They gave us wetsuits, all the snorkel gear. The manatees make their way into Florida for the warm waters during the winter. So the best time to see them is November through February. Because it's like the coldest in the Gulf waters. And we got in the water, which was 72 degrees. It's that temperature all year. But I must say, being in the water for about an hour, we were shivering pretty
good. It was cold.
And if you're not looking to swim with them, you can paddle through the spring area. And they have these kayaks that are clear that you can paddle.
Oh,
so you
yeah,
can
that's
see
cool.
right into the water.
I've never been in one, but they always look pretty neat. They do.
Let's launch right into the next one and talk about Kennedy Space Center. Did you like that?
I see what you did there.
Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to run these by me. Okay, I'm the one with the dad jokes here.
Catching you off guard. I love it. Located in Cape Canaveral, Florida. The cool part about Kennedy Space Center is amazing for all ages.
Yeah.
There's so much to see there that they actually offer like 2-day passes for cheaper. But if you just want to go for one day, $75 per adult and $65 per child. Now, we did go on a launch day, so it was much busier than normal. So that is the price you pay if you want to go and see a rocket launch and just kind of do it all at once. Do you remember going to the Apollo Saturn V area via bus?
You literally walk in and it's just like this huge rocket hanging off the ceiling. It's overwhelming.
Yeah.
It's really neat to see.
Speaking of rockets, if you do want to see a rocket launch and they're having one that day, I recommend getting tickets to the Banana Creek viewing area. It's an additional $20 per person. And don't show up at the last second like we did, because we had to stand like off to the side.
But we got some good footage of it. And this is the closest area you can be physically to that rocket launching. When you're there, you're there.
You're there and you feel the thrust, the thrusters. You feel the, what's it called?
The stuff.
You feel the rumble.
The jet fuel, the craziness, the adrenaline. It's there for you. It's waiting for the taking. Don't be like heading down to like Miami area. It's a little too busy there. Head over to the Gulf Coast of Florida.
Specifically, we're talking about more like the Panhandle Gulf Coast beaches.
Mm-hmm. Very budget friendly for you and the fam if you just don't want to make the drive all the way down Florida.
The area is also called 30A, and nope, it doesn't mean 30 amp. Totally thought that every time I saw the sign. I was like, why are they talking about electricity? 30A Highway, which takes you from kind of Destin area all the way to Rosemary Beach. The best part is that the beaches and the water are so clean and water's clear that you can snorkel right there or even go out and dive.
The reef is like accessible by just swimming out, which is really neat. Actually, we did a whole video on this and it was phenomenal. So definitely check that one out too after if you're interested in the snorkeling scuba diving thing. We got you covered there as well.
We visited Topsail and Grayton Beach State Park, and oh my gosh, the beaches there, it feels like you're in the Keys without having to go all the way to the Keys.
Out of all of these, my personal favorite place to go in Florida, the most spectacular thing I have ever seen in Florida, and I cannot wait to go back, is King's Landing.
King's Landing is a post, like a launch dock, that takes you into the beautiful clear waters of Rock Run Springs. And this is central Florida area of Apopka, Florida, which is north of Orlando.
But you're just, it's so quiet, crystal clear water. And trees are just birds. It's just, it's ridiculous. Now down to the nitty gritty, it is $10 to launch your own boat. And you should definitely make reservations rather than just trying to show up on the doorsteps and be like, please let me in.
Yeah, that's risky. We got in, but I think it's because we had our own boat.
Yeah.
But if you want to rent a boat or a kayak or do a guided tour, definitely try to make a reservation online. But just know that if you're going with your own boat, your own vessel, you need to have a life vest. And since it's a privately owned launching area, they will check your coolers going out. So no alcohol. Mm-hmm. They don't want you to have like booming speakers and make it a crazy party scene. So yeah. There's rules, okay?
Which is good because it allows you to be a little more immersed and just enjoy the experience for what it is, yes. Which I really appreciated. So
if you go to King's Landing and you launch from their dock, you're gonna see that the water isn't crystal clear right from the dock. Mm-hmm. Don't worry, you're gonna paddle forward to where you get to the first like T in the water. All of a sudden you're gonna see crystal clear water.
So cool.
Take a right. You are gonna be going against the current, but you're gonna go to the right and you're gonna paddle for about 1 or 2 hours upstream. Mm-hmm. It's doable until you come to a bridge where you can't go any further, and that's where Kelly Park is. We always recommend you go against the current and then float your way back.
Hard than easy.
You know what else is interesting? I read pets are not allowed at King's Landing. So if you have a dog that really likes to go paddling with you, supposedly per the website, it's a no-go.
Back to what I was saying about landing a spot down in the Florida Keys. Everyone says it's impossible to do. You gotta make it a year in advance reservation. Let me tell you, you're flat out wrong. We made a reservation for a week and we did it at the very last minute, and so can you. And we're gonna tell you exactly how to do it in this video right here. Go check it out. We'll see you over there and we'll see you guys next week. Love y'all.
Bye guys.
Bye.